Ayurveda is an ancient medical science, as we all know. It is my responsibility to let you all know that Ayurveda is not only the science for treatment and medicines, but also a science for living. So the diseases and the treatments are explained elaborately in one half of the textbook, but it all started with how to live, when to wake up, how to take bath, how to brush, what all ingredients to be used for brushing, etc., etc. Recently, people started to come towards the nature and Ayurveda became famous. If you go to the market, everything is Ayurvedic today. Ayurvedic toothpaste, Ayurvedic soap, Ayurvedic shampoo, Ayurvedic whatnot. Anything attached with Ayurvedic as prefix is sold well today, right? But today, let us see whether today's Ayurvedic toothpaste is really Ayurvedic. Before analyzing the Ayurvedic toothpaste, first, let us understand why we chose Ayurveda than the normal toothpaste. So, people who have already shifted from normal toothpaste, you all must have known about fluoride, sodium lauryl sulfate, sodium benzoate and other chemicals. These three are the common ingredients of a normal general toothpaste. First, let's see what fluoride is, why it is used, what role it plays in brushing. Fluoride is something which is claimed to protect the teeth by forming a layer on the teeth. But the disadvantage of fluoride is it is toxic in nature. Fluoride is so much toxic that in the toothpaste in the US, it is written that if you accidentally swallow more than used for brushing, seek professional help or contact a poison control center immediately. In 2010, in CDC, it is reported that 41% of American adolescents had a condition known as dental fluorosis, discoloring of tooth enamel caused by too much of fluoride. Animal experiment shows that fluoride over time accumulates in the brain and hampers learning abilities, and abnormal behavior changes are noticed. There is a general argument that fluoride only when consumed is a problem, but anyway, we are spitting out during the process of brushing and it is okay as far as brushing is concerned. But I don't think so, because there is a book called Physician's Desk Reference where it is mentioned that the mucosal lining in the mouth has an absorption efficacy of more than 90%. So whatever fluoride is releasing in the process of brushing is immediately absorbed into the bloodstream and affects the body adversely. For decades, fluoride has been considered the solution for decaying teeth, but it's been receiving increasing scrutiny in recent years. A groundbreaking study published in journal Langmuir uncovered that fluoride layer formed on the teeth is mere 6 nanometers thick. To understand just how thin this is, you would need 10,000 of these layers to get the width of a strand of the hair. Scientists now question whether this ultra-thin layer can actually protect the enamel and provide any benefit. Now let's come to sodium lauryl sulfate. Sodium lauryl sulfate is present not only in the toothpaste but also in the soaps, shampoos, etc. The foaming action is because of the sodium lauryl sulfate present in these products. This chemical, which is also called as SLS, irritates the taste buds in our mouth and it also hampers the functioning of taste buds by breaking down the phospholipids present on the tongue. Also, SLS is attributed to recurring sores in the mouth. The third ingredient, which is again harmful for us, is sodium benzoate. Sodium benzoate is a general preservative used across the globe, except Europe. Europe has banned sodium benzoate, but still many other countries are still using sodium benzoate. Sodium benzoate is so harmful that when it comes in contact with vitamin C, it has potential to cause even cancer. It is carcinogenic. By all this, we understood that the normal toothpaste is not good for our buccal cavity, our health, whatever, etc., etc. Now, let us come to Ayurvedic toothpaste. We go for Ayurveda because it is herbal and it is non-toxic. It is supposed to be non-toxic. But unfortunately, all the three ingredients, or at least one of the three ingredients, is added even in Ayurvedic toothpaste. All companies, you take any Ayurvedic company, it is adding one of these dangerous ingredients, making it toxic again. What is the point in adding so many herbal ingredients when the base itself is wrong? You every day brush with the toothpaste, right? Every day you are getting in touch with whatever material you are using for brushing. If such chemicals are coming into contact with your teeth and gums, How do you expect your oral cavity to be healthy if the paste available in the market is not good or not up to the mark? So what is the solution now? This may be the thought in your mind for now, right? So you might think that I am going to suggest you to go and brush with neem twigs or other twigs, right? Even in Ayurveda, there are references which has suggested about toothpastes keeping the base as honey. How many of you know that honey doesn't have an expiry date? Honey is one among the best preservatives. So keeping base as honey is a brilliant idea. So what our ancestors did was, there are a few medicines which are good for teeth and gums are infused into this honey and made it into a toothpaste. There is a reference in Ayurveda in Bhava Prakasha Nigantu where he has asked us to brush with a base made out of honey and Trikata Churna. So what we have done is we have searched deeper and found many other herbal medicines which are absolutely safe for our teeth and gums, and we have improvised on this and made a toothpaste out of it. So this may be called as a real Ayurvedic toothpaste because there are absolutely no chemicals added in it and it has an infinite shelf life, I would say. It may not give you froth during brushing because it doesn't have sodium lauryl sulfate in it, but definitely it will keep your mouth fresh and your teeth clean and your oral cavity healthy. So somebody asked me to do a video on toothpaste and brushing, so hence this video. Thank you.
You can buy our Vedanta toothpaste from liveindiantradition.com. The link is provided in the description. We even have other Indian traditional products too. Do you subscribe to our channel to be updated with our latest videos? If you like this video, please share it with your friends. And if you have any opinions or questions, do write them in the comment section below.